Hi friends, good morning. Today let us do some MCET problems, that is 2019 and 2018 MCET problems, so that you will get an idea how the questions will be. Okay friends, today our first problem is, this is 2019 problem. Find the equation of the parabola whose axis is parallel to the x-axis. Equation of the parabola which is parallel to the x-axis and which passes through the points minus 2, 1, 2, −1, 3. See, first friends, so we want the parabola, equation of the parabola parallel to the x-axis and passing through these three points. That is the question. First thing, equation of the parabola parallel to the x-axis. Parallel to the x-axis is x is equal to ay square plus by plus c. This is the equation of the parabola parallel to the x-axis. This is the general equation of a parabola. Y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. That is parallel to y-axis. This is parallel to x-axis. X is equal to ay square plus by plus c. This equation, this parabola is passing through these three points. So we can substitute these three points in this equation. We get three equations in A, B, C, and by solving them we get the values of A, B and C, and put those values in the equation to get the final equation of the parabola. Right friends? So first I am substituting this point. −2 is equal to x is equal to ay square, 1 square 1, 1 into a, a plus 1 into b, b plus c. This is the first equation friends, a plus b plus c is equal to −2. Now I am substituting this point. X is equal to a y square means 4, 4a plus y 2, 2b plus c. This is equation 2 friends. Now I am substituting this point. −1 is equal to a into 3 square 9a plus by 3, 3b plus c. This is equation 3. Let us do 2 minus 1. Equation 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1 gives 2 minus 1. 4a minus a, 3a, 2b minus b, b, c gets cancelled. 1 minus of −2 is equal to 3. This is equation 4. Next, let us do 3 minus 2 friends. 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2. 9a minus 4a, 5a, 3b minus 2b plus b is equal to −1, −1, −2. This is equation 5. So solving 4 and 5, we get the values of a and b, and let us substitute here, we get the c. Okay friends, let us subtract, bb gets cancelled, −2a is equal to 5, a is equal to −5/2, a is equal to friends, −5/2. Let us put this value in the equation 4. 3 into minus 5/2. −15/2 plus b is equal to 3. It implies b is equal to 3 plus 15 by 2, that is equal to 21 by 2. 2, 3, 6 plus 15, 21 by 2. So let us put these values in the equation 1. A plus b plus c is equal to minus 2. A plus b plus c is equal to minus 2. A plus b plus c is equal to minus 2. LCM 2, minus 5, plus 21, plus 2c is equal to minus 2. 2c is equal to minus 4, 21 minus 5 is 16, minus 16. 2c is equal to minus 20, c is equal to minus 10. So let us put these ABC values in the general equation. X is equal to ay square, a minus 5 by 2, minus 5 by 2 y square, plus b 21 by 2, 21 by 2 y plus c. So x is equal to minus 5 y square plus 21 y plus 2c by 2. On cross multiplication, 2x is equal to minus 5y square plus 21y plus 2c. 2c means c value minus 10. C value minus 10. Minus 20. Minus 20. So it implies 5y square plus 21y minus 21 by plus 2x plus 20 is equal to 0. This is the required equation, friends. 5y square minus 21y plus 2x plus 20 is equal to 0. This is the required equation, friends. Okay, friends, we shall do simple problem. But this thing first you have to write. Parallel to x-axis, x is equal to ay square plus by plus c, parallel to y square, y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. The second problem, friends, the tangent to the parabola y square is equal to 4ax. The tangent to the parabola y square is equal to 4ax from an external point P. From an external point P, make angles theta 1 and theta 2 with the axis of the parabola, such that tan theta 1 plus tan theta 2 is equal to b. So this line makes an angle of theta 1 and theta 2, theta 1 and theta 2 with the axis of the parabola. This is axis of this parabola. One is theta 1 and another is theta 2. See, friends, say this Q. Here the problem is, this is y square is equal to 4ax parabola, and two tangents are drawn from an external point P, say touching the parabola at point Q and R. These tangents are making an angles of theta 1 and theta 2 with the axis of the parabola. Now, and one more small condition is given. Tan theta 1 plus tan theta 2 is equal to small b. Tan theta 1 plus tan theta 2 is equal to small b. Then What is the locus of B? P. What is the locus of P? Okay, friends. See, we can take any point Q, 81 square plus 281, that you know. So, equation of the tangent PQ. Yt1 is equal to x plus 81 square. This is the equation of the tangent PQ. Equation of the tangent PR. Say the point is 82 square comma 282. Point on parabola. So the equation of the tangent PR. Yt2 is equal to x plus 82 square. Let us find the point of intersection of these two points. That is, we get the values of x and y. We get the values of x and y. After that, we will consider the given condition tan theta 1 plus tan theta 2 is equal to small b. That is the given condition. Then we can find the locus of b. That is, p lies on which equation. I am solving these two equations, friends. Solving these two equations. Y into T1 minus T2 subtracting 1 minus 2 is equal to A into T1 square minus T2 square. Y is equal to A into T1. T1 square minus T2 square is equal to T1 minus T2 into T1 plus T2. A square minus B square is equal to A plus B into A minus B. So, T1 minus T2 gets cancelled. Here, T1 plus T2 will remain. A into T1 plus T2. This is the value of Y. And to find the value of X, let us substitute this value in the first equation. Y. A T1 into T1 plus T2. A T1 into T1 plus T2. Is equal to x plus a t1 square. A t1 square plus a t1 t2 is equal to x plus a t1 square. A t1 square, a t1 square gets cancelled. X is equal to a t1 t2. This is value of x, and value of y is this. You can remember these two values in further. The point of intersection of two tangents which are in this form is x is equal to a into t1 t2, y is equal to a into t1 plus t2. Now we got the point of intersection of P, these two tangents P. But here let us find the values of t1 and t2. For that, what is given, friends? Tan theta 1. These two lines are making theta 1 and theta 2 angles with the axis. So, tan theta 1, that is the slope of this first line. See, minus a by b. Okay, friends. So, this equation can be written as y is equal to xy T1, I am sending this side, x by T1 plus AT1, y is equal to x by T1 plus AT1. So, the coefficient of y is equal to mx plus c form, sees, y is equal to mx plus c, so m is slope, 1 by T1, tan theta is equal to 1 by T1, tan theta is equal to 1 by T1, in the same way, tan theta 2 is equal to 1 by t2. Now given that tan theta 1 plus tan theta 2 is equal to b. So using that condition, 1 by t1 plus 1 by t2 is equal to small b. It implies t1 plus t2 is equal to small b. t1 plus t2 is equal to y by a. y by a by t1 t2 एक्स बाय ए इज इक्वल टू बी, ए गेट्स कैंसिल, वाई इज इक्वल टू बी एक्स, वाई इज इक्वल टू बी एक्स, दिस इज द रिक्वायर्ड लोकस ऑफ बी, वाई इज इक्वल टू बी एक्स, दैट इज द रिक्वायर्ड लोकस. ओके फ्रेंड्स, प्रॉब्लम इज वेरी सिंपल. वॉट वी डिड, इक्वेशन ऑफ द टू टैंजेंट्स and the point of intersection of the two tangents, and after finding the point of intersection of the two tangents, we have substituted the values of t1 plus t2 into t1 t2, so by using this condition. Okay friends, let us see the third problem. Friends, the line y is equal to 6x plus 1. Touches the parabola y square is equal to 24x. This line touches the parabola y square is equal to 24x. Parabola equation is that. We want the coordinates of a point P on this line from which the tangent to this parabola is perpendicular to this line. So we want another tangent. See, the coordinates of a point P on this line, from which the tangent to this same parabola is perpendicular to this line. So this tangent is the perpendicular to this tangent. So we have to find P. Here the angle between these two tangents is say 90 degrees. So these two are perpendicular tangents. First, what is given? This line is tangent to this parabola, that is fine. Now he is asking the point that the tangent drawn to this same parabola is perpendicular to this line. That is, these two are perpendicular tangents. Right, friends? Friends, the conclusion what we know is, the point of intersection, the locus of point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents, this is one point. And again, we can draw another set of perpendicular tangents. So accordingly we get points. So the locus of point of intersection of the tangents is nothing but the directrix of the parabola. So this point, that is point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents. Lies on the directrix. So what is the equation of the directrix? This is, friends, the given parabola is y square is equal to 4ax. That is right open. So then x is equal to minus a is the equation of the directrix. What is a? 4a is equal to 24. a is equal to 6. So x is equal to minus 6 is the equation of the directrix.
X is equal to minus 6. X is equal to minus 6 is the equation of the directrix.
Let us put the value. Let us put the value here. Y is equal to 6 into minus 6. Minus 36 plus 1. Y is equal to minus 35. Y is equal to minus 35.
So x is equal to minus 6 comma minus 35. Minus 6 comma minus 35 is the
point P. Point of intersection of these two perpendicular tangents. So the only thing we have to remember is always the point of intersection of the locus of the point of intersection of
two perpendicular tangents
is directrix. So directrix equation we know, for y square is equal to 4ax, the directrix is x is equal to minus u. So x is equal to minus 6 is the directrix equation. X is equal to minus 6, we substitute, then we get the value of y. So the point P is minus 6 comma minus 35. That is the point he is asking, the point only. He is asking the point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents. Okay friends, let us see one more problem. See friends, I ask you a small thing. See, what is the locus of the point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents drawn to the parabola x square is equal to 4ay? Tell me. The parabola is x square is equal to 4ay. The parabola is x square is equal to 4ay. X square is equal to 4ay. And the locus of point of intersection of the perpendicular tangents. Locus of the intersection of the perpendicular tangents. This locus. Is the directrix. X square is equal to 4ay is the given parabola. So for x square is equal to 4ay parabola, the directrix is y is equal to minus a. So y is equal to minus a. Is your answer. Simple answer. Y is equal to minus a. Okay, friends, that bit also you remember. Okay, look at this problem friends. This is also asked in your concept. It's just I orally said and quit because we have done this problem yesterday. Find a point on the parabola whose focus is S1, -1 friends, and whose vertex is 1, 1. This is the S focus, this is the vertex. Yesterday we did 2-3 problems. Finding the equation of the parabola when focus and vertex are given. You can do in two ways, but here the x coordinates are equal. See, focus is 1, -1. Focus is 1, 1, -1. This is the focus. And vertex is 1, 1. Vertex is 1, 1. This is the vertex 1, 1. This is focus 1, -1. So focus lies inside the parabola. Focus lies inside the parabola. So the parabola must be like this. The parabola must be like this. This is x square is equal to -4a/y parabola. This is x square is equal to -4a/y parabola. So friends, this is a vertex. This is focus. This is a focus. And we can find the equation of parabola. What is that? x minus h whole square is equal to -4a into y minus k. So we can find a the distance between these two points. Distance between these two points is a. The distance between focus and vertex. The distance between focus and vertex, that is 1 + 1, 2 units. So, A is 2, vertex is given. So, our equation is x minus h whole square is equal to -4a into y minus k. H is known, vertex hk. Are known, h and k are known, and a, the distance between these two points, you can find root of x2 minus x1 whole square or y2 minus, like that also you can do. So here a is the distance between these two points, 1 minus 1 0 whole square, minus 1 minus 2 whole square, 4, under root 4 means 2. So a2, x minus h is equal to 1. X minus h whole square is equal to minus 4 into 2 minus 8 into y minus 1. This is the equation of the, this is the equation of the parabola. Here the small extension, friends. Here the small extension. He is asking a point on the parabola whose focus is 1 minus 1 and whose vertex is 1, 1. We know how to find the equation of the parabola when focus and vertex are given. Right, friends? That is one thing. After getting the equation of the parabola, you can substitute the options from in this equation. So only one option will satisfy this equation. The point given in the options, the point which satisfies this equation is the required point. Okay, friends, let us do the last problem for today's session. The parabola x square is equal to 4ay. The parabola x square is equal to 4ay. This is x square is equal to 4ay parabola. The parabola x square is equal to 4ay makes an intercept of length root 40 units on the line y is equal to 1 + 2x. Intercept form. What is intercept length? Then the value of 4a is intercept root. It is equal to root 40. I shall read the problem once again, friends. The parabola x square is equal to 4ay makes an intercept of length root 40 units on the line y is equal to 1 + 2x, then the value of 4a is. Friends, you know the length of the chord intercepted from line y is equal to mx plus c by parabola x square is equal to 4ay is. This you remember, friends. 4 into root of
a into 1 plus m square into c plus am square. C plus am square. This is the length of the chord intercepted by the x square by intercepted on the line y is equal to 1 plus 2x. This is the length of the chord intercepted by the line y is equal to mx plus c by parabola x square is equal to 4ay. This is the equation, friends. Equation x square is equal to 4ay intercept form. Intercept. That intercept is given. What is that intercept? Root 40. Here we know m. M is equal to, we don't know a. We have to find a. He is asking what is the value of 4a. In this formula, intercept formula, length of intercept. M we know, y is equal to mx plus c, m is equal to 2, and c is 1, and length is equal to root 40. This is equal to root 40. 4 into root of, substitute these values, a plus a into 1 plus m square, m 2 square, 4 into c plus 1 plus a into m square 4, that is 4a, is equal to root 40, squaring on both sides, 16 into 5a, 1 plus 4, 5a into 1 plus 4a is equal to 40. Two fives, 10a plus 2 fours, 2a, 2 fives, 10a, 2 twenties, 40a square is equal to 5. It implies on dividing with 5, 8a square plus 2a minus 5 is equal to 0. Friends, whether you have done correctly, see once again, let us see which is verified. 2 5's 10a plus 2 5's 10a into 40a square is equal to 16. Right. 10a next to 40 is 8 5's, 8 2's, 8 1's. Five eights, five twos, five ones is equal to 0. So the factors of this one is, friends, 8a square, 8 ones, 8, 4 twos, 8. 8a square plus 4a minus 2a minus 1 is equal to 0. 4a into 2a plus 1 minus 1 into 2a plus 1 is equal to 0. So 4a minus 1 into 2a plus 1 is equal to 0. So a is 4a, first one, 4a is equal to 1. Second a is equal to minus 1 by 2. 4a is equal to 4 into minus 1 by 2, minus 2. So the values of 4a, 1 or minus 2. 1 or, here we got straight away 4a value. Here we got a value minus 1 by 2, 4a value 4 into minus 1 by 2, minus 2. Okay, friends, this formula you have to remember, when the parabola is x square is equal to 4ay, then the intercept
the length of the intercept intercepted by this line intercepted by y is equal to mx plus c on this parabola is this. And another formula is also there, friends. I shall write for your convenience. See, length of the intercept by the parabola on the line y is equal to mx plus c.
This is the
length of the intercept that is equal to root 40. This problem is over, friends. See, remember this point also. length of the chord intercepted by the parabola y square is equal to 4ax. If the given parabola is y square is equal to 4ax, then the length of the intercept by the parabola on the line y is equal to mx plus c is 4 by m square into root of a into 1 plus m square into 8 plus cm. This formula you note down, friends. So once you know this formula, you can substitute the value of m, you can substitute the value of c, and then by equating the intercept distance length, you can find the value of a. After finding the value of a, you can also find the equation of the parabola. Here 4a is equal to 1, so x square is equal to y, or when you substitute -2, x square is equal to -2y is another parabola. So you can also find the equations of the parabola by finding the values of 4a. Okay, friends, thank you. Let's have a nice day. Okay, friends.